Okay, children, welcome back. We are starting with a new topic today, and for that, let us take two biscuits. Okay, what? Two biscuits. Parle ji, very simply available in all the houses. If supposing not, no problem. You can take any two biscuits. Okay, and cookies. And you place one on top of the other. Like for example, this is one parle ji. This is one parle ji. And place one on top of the other. What will you see? That this parle ji completely hides the second biscuit. Yes, the first cookie completely hides the second one. Correct? Yes. So, if this coinciding is possible, can we say this parle ji is equal in shape and size of this parle ji biscuit? Yes. Yes, we can say. Correct? We can say. So, such figures which are equal in shape and size, they are known as congruent figures. Okay? They are known as congruent figures, and the property is known as congruency, which is a new chapter today. Congruency. Congruency only, na? Congruency of triangles. So, this is a new chapter for today, which we are starting. That is chapter number 7, congruency. And what is congruency? It is the property of showing congruent figures. That is, when the figures are equal in length, okay, or equal in size, equal in shape. Okay, so this is, we took one normal example. Now let's take any figure. Okay, for example, let's take the figure which is in your book. This is figure 1. And this is figure 2. So how can we show the congruency, or we can show that these two figures are congruent? Very simple. Take a tracing paper, trace out F1 and place it on F2. If F1 is totally coinciding with F2, that means figures are congruent figures. Okay, and that means we show like this. Measure of figure 1 is equal to the measure of figure 2, or figure 1 is congruent. After equal sign, we show, put a sign of similarity. Na? It is similar. Figure 1 is similar to figure 2. Okay, so this is the sign of congruency, or the sign of for the showing the figures to be congruent. Yaad rakhna, congruent koi naya shabd nahi hai, kahin se nikal ke nahi aaya hai. It only means equality, jo abhi tak hum karte aaye. We measure, yes. Abhi right now we were doing what? We were using the properties of the triangles, right? There was only one triangle. Now there will be two triangles and we'll have to compare. Okay, ye wala triangle kya iske barabar hai ki nahi? And if we do that, that is the congruency. Ek bas ek naya word de diya hai, just for fashion. But it means what? Equality. मतलब क्या ये figure इसके बराबर है कि नहीं? इसके equal है कि नहीं? The measure of this figure is equal to the measure of that figure or not? And if the answer is yes, then the figures are said to be congruent figures. Okay? And this word congruency, you're going to use it in your entire life till you are studying. Like that is, for example, after class 10th, if you take 11th and 12th mathematics, then you're going to study congruency. Okay, so nothing new. It is just we named it. So this, we studied the congruency of a figure. Let's study the congruency of PQ, put it on AB. If both are matching, the measure is same of both, then we can say line PQ is congruent to line AB. Okay, so you can say in both ways. Since their measures are equal, therefore the figures are, the lines are congruent, or since they are congruent, their measure is equal. Their lengths are same. So this is about line. Let's take angle. Let's take angle. So like for example, let's take, suppose this is an angle. Angle PQR. Okay. And one more angle. Angle ABC. Let's take one more angle. Angle LMN. Let's take one more angle. Angle XYZ. Now, this angle is 40 degree. This angle is also 40 degree. This angle is 20 degree and this angle is 40 degree. So, again you can trace out. If you want, you can trace out and you can see the measures and you can find out the congruency. Trace out PQR, put it on ABC. Will they match? Yes, they will match because their measurements are same. So, they both are congruent, right? Because their measure is same. Or you can say they are equal in measure. Then again you trace out, put on LMN. Are they congruent? No. Why? Because here the measurement of angle PQR is not equal to the measurement of angle LMN. Okay, seeing the measurements also we can compare. Then again we compare these two, that is XYZ and PQR, and we see that since the measures are again same, obviously when you put a tracing paper here, after tracing PQR, you will see that the arms will coincide with one another. Therefore, these two angles are also congruent angles. Similarly, we test the congruency of triangles. Okay, same way. Triangle A, B, C, triangle P, Q, R. Now, if these two sides are same, these two sides are same, these two sides are same, or these angles are equal, okay, correspondingly these angles are equal, then the triangles are said to be congruent triangles. An angle can be measured in the on the basis of its side. Triangle can be measured on the basis of either their sides or the angles. Okay, so how can we find out whether a given triangles are congruent or not? Either we measure their sides, okay, or we measure their angles. Okay, so when we are measuring this side, we measure this side only. If we are measuring this side, we measure this side, that is the base and the third side. Okay, so this completes the congruency. Okay, so the congruency of the triangles have equal shape and size. So if they are congruent, then we can write like this: triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR if their sides or their size and shapes are equal. Okay, now we have corresponding vertices, which I already told you, corresponding sides, corresponding. So we have corresponding vertices, we have corresponding sides, and we have corresponding angles. Corresponding vertices, जो ऊपर ऊपर वाले हैं, A and A, A and P are corresponding vertices. Similarly, B and Q are corresponding vertices. Same तरफ पे हैं. And C and R are corresponding vertices. Similarly, AB and PQ are the corresponding sides. BC and QR are the corresponding sides. AC and PR are the corresponding sides. Similarly, angle B and angle Q are corresponding angles. Angle A and angle P are corresponding angles. Angle C and angle R are corresponding angles. Then there is an exercise which we are going to start after Raksha Bandhan. Okay, so happy Raksha Bandhan to all.